Today on Warrior Update. We honor America's veterans, staff runs for charity, and Wubanzi beats Niqua. It's Friday, November 13th. I'm Sophie Cornwell, and this is Warrior Update. Wubanzi hosted its annual Veterans Day Assembly this week. Nicole Chung reports.
On Tuesday, November 10th, Wubanzi put on its annual Veterans Day Assembly. With a primary goal of honoring local veterans and educating students on the importance of service, the event has become a staple in Wubanzi community.
I think it brings it down to grassroots in America and gives a little captured moment of those that have served in uniform, and they might serve as well.
We feel it's a very strong drive or a very strong need of ours to educate the students on what it means to serve our country.
So I've been to a few. This is by far the best and most well-run. Mr. Schmidgall does a great job setting this up. It's phenomenal. It felt great to be back and see all these service members.
I think it's really important that we have this Veterans Assembly to honor our veterans, obviously, in their service before self, and honor the people who are going to go into that situation. And I think it's really a really cool thing that we do.
I think it's great. A lot of times the sacrifice is lost in day-to-day lives, and it's nice to come together and recognize that sacrifice is made, but also to recognize that the real sacrifice is made by the families of the veterans.
We were totally amazed the first time we saw it. Yes. Now we realize that this is what you do, and we are so grateful that you remember every year.
We're honored that you do this every year. It's just amazing to see this, and we thank you.
Most of my family was in military somehow, in what branch, and it's great. It's great to honor everyone who served or who did serve, and it's really good. I like it a lot.
Above all else, the speakers and the coordinators hope students left with a greater understanding of the sacrifice of service.
I thought it was tremendous from the speeches, from the students, as well as the chorus and the musicians, and the symphony was phenomenal.
I enjoy talking to the student body and to the faculty about the precious freedom that we have to currently maintain throughout the United States of America.
Thank you for everything that you've done, and I really appreciate the effort that everyone went to today.
For Warrior Update, I'm Nicole Chung.
More Wubanzi staff were added again, running for charity this weekend. Lauren Howard reports.
This past Sunday, members of the Warrior community participated in the Naperville Half Marathon, raising money to support the Indian Prairie Educational Foundation.
Well, I always love representing IPEF for all the work they do for the schools, the District 204, and also represent Wubanzi. I'm kind of running on the fumes of last night after the big victory, so that got me through the last 3 miles. So, yeah, it's a great run, beautiful day to run.
I've run a lot of races just as an individual. I really wanted to, with my senior class this year, give back to them and show them that, like, when you're running for a cause, like, it makes it that much easier. So it was really great to help support the great things the district is doing and just be out there supporting Wubanzi.
While supporting IPEF, the runners faced some challenges during the race.
The last 3 miles, I was running, like, closer to an 8-minute mile, so I was getting a little frustrated. It's a very hilly course.
Just the last couple weeks tapering with the cross-country team, I didn't get the miles I wanted, but it was still a great race today.
Having racing experience helped them with this opportunity.
This is my second half marathon. I've ran a couple marathons, but half marathon's a good race for me.
There's a marathon out in California that I do in springtime.
In addition to Stipen Van Kampen, Megan Doherty, Jareen Roderick, Adam Deich, and Pat Doyle ran for Wubanzi. For Warrior Update, I'm Lauren Howard.
The Naperville Park District honored veterans this week. Warrior Update has more.
The Naperville Park District created the Healing Field, an area of American flags near the Carillon Tower in Naperville to honor America's veterans.
The Healing Field is a display of 2015 flags here in Naperville to honor men and women who have served and are currently serving in the military. It's an opportunity for veterans, individuals who are family members of veterans and military members to come and reflect and to honor their service within the military and, you know, what they've sacrificed for the freedoms that we all have.
Veterans appreciate the recognition now, especially for those who served at a time when war was not a popular political option.
Now people are starting to realize that these guys were sent over there by their government, and they had nothing to do with whether they wanted to go or not. They just went. So I had good friends that were spit on and everything else you can think of and called all kinds of names, and yet they served their country and did what they thought was right. But when they came back to this country, they were told, don't wear your uniform. But many of them wore their uniforms because they were proud of it. I look around and I see children now growing up in a free nation and being able to grow up and do what they want to do. And this is the only nation in the world that that's possible.
For Warrior Update, I'm Alyssa Pappas.
And now a word from our sponsor.
Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go.
Model UN hosted a conference last month. Warrior Update has more.
On October 17th, Waubonsie Valley hosted their 6th annual WV Model United Nations Conference. Delegates represent different countries and discuss topics based on their country's beliefs. They have the opportunity to win various awards from their committee, including Best Position Paper, Honorable Mention, and Best Delegate.
Model Nations is a club for people who like to discuss about politics and they like debate. It's a club where you basically emulate the topics that United Nations would talk about relating to human rights, or it can be something fun like NBA Owners Committee, which we had at our past conference. And it's basically for people who like talking about political topics and also like who like debate, who like writing resolutions, who basically just want to, you know, see peace in the world, and that's what the UN is all about.
Model UN is a great way for students to improve their public speaking skills as well as becoming more knowledgeable about the world around them.
I used to be a really bad speaker and always public speaker, and Model UN really helped me with that, being able to speak in front of big crowds and not being really afraid when talking in front of people, even though if you think you're saying something wrong or whatever it is, just builds that confidence which I needed and it was able to build throughout freshman year to senior year.
For Warrior Update, I'm Caroline Kittredge.
Waubonsie and Niqua clashed again last week in the playoffs. Warrior Update has more.
Waubonsie Valley continued its playoff run last Saturday with a win at Neuqua Valley. It was a team effort led by 190 yards rushing from Max Irie.
You know, with Max, all you got to do is just give him a little head start, and probably not many people are going to tackle him. Our line did great all night. They just kept making holes for him, and then, you know, that was just Max being Max.
We decided that we were going to pound the ball in the second half, and that was big in the key that we knew Max was going to be running real hard. We were able to switch some things around at halftime to block it a little bit different.
The adjustment worked as Waubonsie came back from a 14-0 deficit.
Yeah, I mean, we were having success around the middle, getting at least 4 yards of carry each time, so we figured, yeah, that'll chew up a lot of clock time, you know, and we had success with it, so why not keep running it?
We gave him some different looks. We gave him a couple different fronts, and, you know, nothing that we did was able to slow him down.
Although there was excitement in beating their rival, the Warriors remained grounded for their upcoming game against Naperville Central.
I mean, each week gets crazier. This is definitely my favorite win so far because it's against our rival, and obviously the first meeting wasn't good. So again, this win is just really special, you know. Just everyone did well. O-line did great. Jack did well. Everybody played great, and that's why we got the win.
I do get that sense of history, but then it is also we're just moving on to the next round. We're just playing great football right now. We definitely play very well against good opponents, and in the playoffs, that's what you need to do. And we've done that 2 weeks now, so we're going to keep it rolling next week.
I just think it shows the league prepares you for the playoffs. So, like Coach Stein said a couple years ago, if you're 5-14, you have the ability to make it to the quarterfinals. We're in the quarterfinals. They're 9-1 or 10-1 or whatever it is. They're in the quarterfinals. They're in the conference champ. Somebody, one of us is going to be in the semis. Somebody in the EVC is going to be in the semis this year. And it's going to be a hell of a game. Don't miss it.
For Warrior Update, I'm Josh Breckenridge.
That's all for Warrior Update. I'm Sophie Cornwell. Thanks for watching.
So.
I mean, shoot, I'm sorry. Sorry, one sec. Mother Nature! That's all for Warrior Update. I'm Vikram Chatterjee. Happy Halloween. Thanks for watching. That's all for... I'm Sophie Cornwell from Jump In.
That's a wrap, Waubonsie. We'll see you next week. Thank you for watching.